Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Ajit Kumar Mahapatra from the Department of Physics and Astrophysics, University of Delhi, Delhi, India. Today we are going to discuss about a module called Second Harmonic Generation and Phase Matching that is coming in chapter Nonlinear Optics under the paper titled Characterization of Materials 2. So students, let us see what we are going to learn in this module. First, we will see the introduction of electromagnetic equations in nonlinear optics and the electromagnetic interaction in second harmonic generation, and then the phase matching of the radiated electric field. In this unit, we are trying to understand the physical origin of optical transmission and the origin of nonlinear optics. Till now, we learned that an expansion of the induced dipole polarization leads to a range of nonlinear effects and the dependence of these effects on the structure of the materials. During the light transmission through the materials, the interaction of light, which is an oscillating electromagnetic wave, with the atoms and molecules present in the materials. One way to understand is that after the photons get absorbed, the excited atom decays via phonon-based processes, leaving the object heated up. Example is a black painted car on a sunny day. The other way is that the photon gets absorbed and then emission takes place at another wavelength through fluorescence. Here, the incoming wave induces an oscillating dipole from the electrons surrounding the molecule, resulting in re-emission of the same wavelength. If the incident light is close to an absorption limit, this process takes longer to take place. In this case, closer to the resonance for absorption, the longer it takes the time for a photon to be re-emitted, making the light slow propagation through the medium and resulting increase in the refractive index. Electromagnetic radiation propagates through space with oscillating electric and magnetic field vectors represented in alternating sinusoidal patterns that are perpendicular to one another and to the direction of wave propagation. The visible light is composed of both electrical and magnetic components, which makes the velocity of light through a substance to partially dependent on the electrical conductivity of the material. Light waves passing through a transparent crystal interact with the localized electrical fields during their journey. The relative speed at which the electrical signals travel through material varies with the type of signal and its interaction with the electronic structure, and is determined by the parameter generally referred as the dielectric constant of the material. The vector relationship defining the interaction between the light wave and the crystal through which it passes is governed by the inherent orientation of the lattice vectors and the direction of electric vector component of the wave. Light wave interaction with an atom or molecule produces an induced dipole polarization moment Pi, and the induced dipole moment per unit volume can be expressed as
P is equal to sum over I Pi, which is equal to epsilon 0 chi and E, where epsilon 0 is the free space permittivity and chi is the polarizability or dielectric susceptibility. From electrostatics, the electric displacement field D can be written as E plus 4 pi P, and this is the Maxwell's equation for a dielectric material. Then equation 1 and 2 implies D is equal to epsilon 0 E plus epsilon 0 chi E is equal to epsilon 0 times 1 plus chi times E is equal to epsilon 0 ER E, where epsilon R is the relative permittivity of the medium. As the light intensity increases, this linear model begins to break down and the polarization of the material is of the form Pi is equal to Xij 1 plus Pi NL. The nonlinearity comes from the nonlinear term in the polarization, which is Pi NL, which depends on E square and higher orders of E. The dipole response is expressed as P is equal to epsilon 0 bracketed sum over j chi ij 1 ej plus sum over jk chi ijk 2 ej ek plus sum over jkl chi ijkl 3 ej ek el plus the higher order terms, which is in the form of P is equal to epsilon 0 chi 1 e plus chi 2 e square plus chi 3 e cube. Thus, excitation of intense radiation on a material can generate nonlinear terms, and we will study the behavior of nonlinear optics based on the chi 2 tensor and are the second order effects. Since every material consists of atoms or molecules, applying an electric field could result in induced polarization in the material that leads to generation of an internal field to get the wave equation inside the material. We substitute the fields into the Maxwell equations. The Maxwell's equations are del dot D is equal to 4 pi rho, del dot B is equal to 0, del cross E is equal to minus 1 by C del B del T, del cross H is equal to 4 pi by C J plus 1 by C del D del T, where rho F is the charge density, C is the velocity of light in vacuum, and J is the current density. Using the above approximations and assumptions, the last two Maxwell's equations yield del cross E plus 1 by C square del square D del T square is equal to 0. To appreciate second harmonic generation and its practical realization, consider classical theory of wave propagation in the medium. Writing the Maxwell's third equation, del cross E is equal to minus del B del T, and taking the curl of the above equation and applying the identity that del cross E is equal to del del dot E minus del square E. We get the solution of EM wave equation in free space. The electromagnetic wave equation is given by del square E minus mu 0 epsilon 0 del square E del t square is equal to 0, which has solution of the form E as a function of R and T is equal to E1 e to the power I multiplied by K1 R minus omega 1 T for electromagnetic wave propagation through a medium. Wave equation becomes del square E minus mu 0 epsilon 0 del square E del T square is equal to mu 0 P, where P is the polarization of the medium, epsilon 0 is the permittivity of air, and mu 0 is the permeability of air. The polarization term in RHS act as a source reflecting the fact that electromagnetic waves are radiated from regions with oscillating polarization. No more plane waves are solution of the wave equation in the medium. Confining nonlinearity up to second order and assuming isotropic case for simplification, the polarization term containing the susceptibility has two components, chi 1 and chi 2. This gives P is equal to epsilon 0 chi E is equal to epsilon 0 chi 1 E plus chi 2 E square is equal to P1 plus P2. The wave equation becomes del square E minus mu 0 epsilon 0 del square E del T square is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 times chi 1 del square E by del T square plus chi 2 del square E square del T square, where the chi 1 term gives linear contribution P1 and the chi 2 term gives nonlinear contribution P2 to the source equation 5. Assuming the solution to be plane waves, in zeroth order approximation, the nonlinear contribution to source term became del square P del T square is equal to epsilon 0 chi 2 del square del T square of E as a function of R and T multiplied by E as a function of R and T. The time varying electric field is represented as E is equal to E1 exponential I to the power K1 R minus omega T. It implies E square is equal to E1 square e to the power 2i times k1 r minus omega t, which implies del square e by del t square is equal to e1 square e to the power 2i times k1 r minus omega t times 4 omega 1 square, where k1 is the absolute value of the propagation vector. Putting equation 8 in 6, we get del square p del t square is equal to minus epsilon 0 chi 2 e1 square 4 omega 1 square times e to the power 2i multiplied by k1 r minus omega 1 t. This equation asserts that the incident wave propagating at frequency omega 1 through the medium simulates the radiation of new waves with frequency omega 2 is equal to 2 omega 1 at every point along the optical path. Thus, every point in the medium acts as an internal source of second harmonic wave of the incident fundamental frequency. The second harmonic electric field DE2 generated by incident wave traveling through distance dr near r is equal to r0 will then have amplitude directly proportional to epsilon 0 chi 2 E1 square 4 omega 1 square multiplied by e to the power 2i times k1 r minus omega 1 t dr. It is seen that the second harmonic field amplitude varies as E1 square. So, SHG intensity is quadratic in Laser intensity. If SHG radiation with above amplitude propagates with wave vector K2, the infinitesimal field generated near R0 will be dE2 is directly proportional to epsilon 0 chi 2 E1 square omega 2 square e to the power 2i times k1r minus omega 1 t multiplied by e to the power I k2 r minus r0. The quantity e to the power I k2 r minus r0 being the phase change accompanying SHG beam propagation from r0 to r. The total SHG field generated at point R is the resultant sum of interfering waves generated between edge of the medium R is equal to R0 and R. E2 is directly proportional to epsilon 0 chi 2 E1 square omega 2 square e to the power 2i times k2 r minus omega 2 t whole multiplied by the integration over 0 to r e to the power I times 2k1 minus k2 r0 and dr0, which gives the value of epsilon 0 chi 2 e1 square omega 2 square e to the power 2i k2 r minus omega 2 t times e to the power I 2k1 minus k2 r0 divided by I times 2k1 minus k2. The SHG frequency omega 2 and wave vector k2 is related to the wave vector and frequency k1 and omega 1 by k1 is equal to n1 omega 1 divided by c, k2 is equal to n2 omega 2 divided by c, and omega 2 is equal to 2 omega 1, k2 is equal to 2 n2 omega 1 divided by c, where n1 and n2 being refractive indices of the medium at frequencies omega 1 and omega 2 respectively. C is the velocity of the light in vacuum. So, the maximum is achieved when the phases are the same. This means the lights should travel the medium at same velocities. This function has a maximum for delta k dot z is equal to 0, and 0 for del k dot z is equal to 2 n pi. This shows that for the most efficient SSG is achieved for delta k is equal to 0. This condition is termed turn edge phase matching, that is, a constant phase relationship is maintained between the generated and propagating waves. For ideal SSG, k2 is equal to 2k1, also n1 omega1 is equal to n1 n2 omega2, called the index matching in equivalent conditions. The maximum useful length for the SSG crystal is equal to LC when no phase matching is present. For maximum I omega 2, we know that sin delta k dot LC divided by 2 is equal to 1, that implies delta k dot LC by 2 is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, LC is equal to pi by delta k. The SSG amplitude oscillates as a function of e to the power I 2k1 minus k2 times r with periodicity LC is equal to pi by 2k1 minus k2, which is equal to pi divided by delta k along the path, and oscillates between a maximum at z is equal to r times LC, where r is an odd integer, and 0 at z is equal to s times LC, where s is an even integer. The distance LC is called coherence length, which is the effective integration length for SSG when delta k not is equal to 0, and is typically several wavelengths in general condensed media. This oscillation caused by interference between SSG waves generated at different points along the path and severely limits the SSG intensity unless the condition delta k is equal to 2k1 minus k2 is 0, which is called the phase matching, is fulfilled. So, a SSG medium, if satisfies phase or index matching, the coherence length is infinite and it leads to complete conversion of fundamental into SSG.
So, the maximum is achieved when the phases are the same. This means the light should travel the medium at same velocity. This function has a maximum for delta k dot g is equal to 0, and 0 value for delta k times z is equal to 2 n pi. This shows that for the most efficient SSG, the delta k value should be 0. This condition is termed as phase matching, that is, a constant phase relationship is maintained between the generated and propagating waves. For ideal SSG, the k2 values should be equal to twice the k1 values, and also n1 omega1 is equal to n2, which is a function of omega2, generally called the index matching in equivalent conditions. The maximum useful length for the SSG crystal is LC when no phase matching is present. So, for our maximum I2 omega, we know that the sin delta k dot IC divided by 2 is equal to 1, which implies the value of delta k dot IC divided by 2 is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, LC is equal to pi divided by delta k. The SHG amplitude oscillates as a function of e to the power I 2k1 minus k2 dot r with periodicity LC is equal to pi by 2k1 minus k2 is equal to pi by delta k along the path and oscillates between a maximum at z is equal to r LC where r is an odd integer and 0 at z is equal to s times LC where s is an even integer. So the distance LC is called the coherence length, which is the effective interaction length for SHG when delta k not is equal to 0 and is typically several wavelengths in general condensed media. This oscillation caused by interference between the SHG waves generated at different points along the path and severely limits the SHG intensity unless the condition delta k is equal to 2k1 minus k2, which is equal to 0, called the phase matching, is fulfilled. So, a SHH medium, if satisfies phase index matching, the coherent length is infinite and it leads to complete conversion of fundamental into SH.
Since isotropic media are normally dispersive, N2 is greater than N1 and index matching is not satisfied, the refractive index for the two different frequencies should be same. The index of refraction is N is directly proportional to square root of epsilon and the permittivity in simple electron model is epsilon, which is a function of omega, is equal to 1 plus 4 pi n e square divided by m sum over j f j divided by minus omega square plus omega j square minus I omega nu j. Thus, as the wavelength increases, the index of refraction decreases. To create the SHG signal, we really need to figure out ways to compensation in refractive index to match the phases. Practical index matching is achieved in bi-refrigerant crystals or double refraction, in which refractive indices differ for the two linear polarizations and depends on direction of propagation. The incident fundamental beam is linearly polarized and the SHG emerges with orthogonal polarization. The propagation direction is adjusted by aligning the crystal such that n1 omega 1 is equal to n2 omega 2 for the respective polarizations. Large SHG conversion efficiencies can be obtained. Another criterion for SHG media is implied by the presence of second order chi2 term in the polarization P. If P includes only all order terms varying as E, E cube, E fifth power, etc., then P function of minus E is equal to minus P the function of minus E. That is, reversing E produces equal and opposite polarization. However, due to chi2 term varying as e to the power 2, p minus e cannot be equal to minus p of minus e. So, SHG is impossible in any medium for which reversing e produces equal but opposite polarization. The isotropic media like liquid, gases and crystals belonging to centrosymmetric space group belonging to such category, and chi 2 vanishes for them by symmetry. The crystal belonging to non-centrosymmetric space group is an example of KDP, which is potassium dihydrogen phosphate. The space group is C1,2m and are suitable for SSG. This result can be understood intuitively by considering the motion of an electron in a non-parabolic potential well. Because of the non-linearity of the associated restoring force, the atomic response will show significant harmonic distortion. Part A of figure 2 shows the waveform of the incident monochromatic electromagnetic wave of frequency omega. For the case of a medium with linear response, as shown in the part B of the figure, there is no distortion of the waveform associated with the polarization of the medium. Part C of the figure shows the induced polarization. For the case of a nonlinear medium that possesses a center of symmetry and whose potential energy function has the form shown in figure 2. Although significant waveform distortion is evident, only odd harmonics of the fundamental frequency are present. For the case shown in part D of a nonlinear, non-centrosymmetric medium having a potential energy function of the form, both even and odd harmonics are present in the waveform associated with the atomic response. Note also the qualitative differences between the waveforms shown in parts C and D. For the centrosymmetric medium in part C, the time average response is 0, whereas for the non-centrosymmetric medium, as in part D, the time average response is non-zero because the medium responds differently to an electric field pointing, say, in the upward direction than to one pointing downward.
So, students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. The phase matching of the radiated electric field of omega and 2 omega is critical in SSG. They have to be in phase so as not to interfere destructively. The incident wave propagating at frequency omega 1 through the medium stimulates the radiation of new waves with frequency omega 2 is equal to 2 omega 1. At every point along the optical path, this is the property of SSG. The bound charges are the source of nonlinear polarization in the material when electromagnetic light passes through it. The light propagation is represented by the electromagnetic waves, and the interaction of light with materials is expressed using the Maxwell's equations. The nonlinearity comes from the nonlinear terms in the polarization, which depends on E square and higher order terms of the electric field. The SSG frequency omega 2 and wave vector k 2 is related to the wave vector and frequency k 1 and omega 1 of the fundamental by k 1 is equal to n 1 omega 1 divided by c, k 2 is equal to n 2 omega 2 divided by c, and omega 2 is equal to 2 omega 1, K2 is equal to 2 N2 omega 1 divided by C, where N1 and N2 being refractive indices of the medium at frequencies omega 1 and omega 2 respectively. A SHG medium, if satisfies the phase or index matching, the coherence length is indefinite and it leads to complete conversion of fundamental into SH. Thank you.